Hello, and welcome back to the Rusty Reclaimer Adventures. We had a little bit of a technical issue, so this is another Take-Two situation. Basically, mods did something weird to my game, and essentially what happened was everything was going fine until I'm like, we're gonna go into the glowing scene. I looked over here to, you know, this power armor suit, and it was a rusted piece of, like, headless T-45 armor, and I was like, no! So I reloaded and got rid of two mods that were the most likely culprits because they were the most, you know, technically, like, unstable. But anywho, yay! It worked! I know, I was afraid it wasn't going to work. But yeah. Gosh. Okay, so, unfortunately this is a save before I was able to, organize my shit. So, I just gotta put away a few things, and then we'll get started. Aw, damn, we even, hey, Turin God, how's it going? I know, there was a lot of content, jeez, in that first little 10 minutes of video. Exterminators, sharp, super mutant crap. Got some shit here. Just trying to do this as quickly as I can. Let's get back to where we were. Anything else? Maybe aid, I guess? Aid. Blood packs. Purified water. Don't need to carry. Razor grain. Potatoes. Okay, so here's an update of which mods I've installed and which ones I uninstalled because I think they did weird shit to my game. So, I installed Traveling Backpack. We don't even have that technically because you need to add it with console commands. So we'll do that. And we also added the Legendary Modifications mod, which makes it so that I can salvage like chipsets off of legendary armor and then use those chipsets to craft other legendaries. It's one chip per legendary equipment, and like some of the things cost like 5 chips or like 10. So like you have to get rid of at least like 20 some things to redo your armor set. But yeah, the other things, yes, thank you. The other things that were kind of weird were, the scrap was one of those things where, like, in the description it said shit may go wrong, as well as, place on red was another one I was trying to get to work. But I don't trust it, because you had to download Cheat Engine in order for it to work. And place on red was a mod that was supposed to be able to make it so that you can place stuff in settlements literally anywhere. Like, I can have a shack sticking out of another shack, and the clipping doesn't matter at all. But, those were pretty, shit may go wrong. Yes, that was the exact, no, that wasn't actually the exact, thing. But yeah, it was pretty much, yeah, it did go wrong, so. We're good now. It was very scary for me to think that, you know, my frickin' X-01 armor suit has been, like, reduced to basically nothing, which was freaking me out. But yeah, so the plan today is I want to go in the glowing sea. Let's showcase the mod one more time. Essentially, I'm going to take a whole bunch of stuff out of here, and we're going to scrap it and get cool stuff out of it. I'll keep all the stuff that gives me like stats, like get rid of most other things that I don't need. Let's see, ghoul slayers we don't need. We don't need hunters. Lucky we'll keep. Don't need those. Yeah, the glowing sea is interesting. I was reading up today on yesterday we tried to do some what is it called? I'm trying to think. We tried to do some legendary farming, which is basically you go to an area which is likely to have legendaries or just a lot of enemies in general. And, basically we went in there, We tried it with a bunch of ghouls, and they didn't really give me good stuff. But apparently, the Glowing Sea, if you're on survival, is freaking crazy with legendaries. And of course, you're fighting, like, Death Claws and, like, some crazy stuff, so... we're gonna definitely work with that. Okay, so...
building something good, I hope.
Basically, the way that this mod works is I get an effect chip every time I have a legendary item. So we're gonna get as many effect chips as I can. A lot of them. Basically, the plan is to make a set of armor for Curie that's completely based off of strength and endurance, so that she can carry the most shit like that anybody could ever carry. Which is the plan. Human cannibals? I don't know. I haven't come across any human cannibals in Fallout 4. You can take a perk that makes you into a cannibal, but I haven't... Maybe I have. You can be... No, you know what? I think we have. We've come across cannibals before. It's sort of loosely inferred that they're cannibals. But definitely they're there. With, you know, raiders that have, like, human heads in the refrigerator and stuff like that. So it's definitely there. Alright, so we're gonna take combat armor. Okay. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make all this polymer combat armor, because it looks better on Curie. I know in the other games, like, you would actually see people being salesmen, and they'd be like, oh, have a piece of this! And they'd give you, like, mysterious meat, and it was obviously, like, some sort of a friggin' crazy thing. So, is it cannibalizing if you eat a super mutant? The upgraded perks of the cannibalism perk lets you eat super mutants. So, yeah. I don't remember... There is, like, a specific town that's like crazy. So as you can see, now armor has like a legendary modification tab, and since I have chips, I got 37 chips, so I can do this. And we're basically going to go with fortifying, which is adding strength and endurance. So what's cool about this mod is depending, there is our difficulty settings actually, so I picked the survival setting difficulty scrap. So like normally you can like remove like a legendary effect from an item, but I'm like, nah, we can't have it be that easy. I need to make some more vegetable starch. There we go. But you know what? Let's take a look at the perk chart and see what we can actually see about that. So we'll go to. Perks. Cannibal's right. Oops. Where is Cannibal? Is it Endurance? I'm not sure where Cannibal is. It's like a dude eating some other dude's arm, right? Ah, it's this one. Here we go. Yep, you can eat mortal flesh to heal your wounds. Eating human corpses restores health. let's see. You can eat ghoul or super mutant corpses, eating ghoul, super mutant, eating those types of things now restores a significant amount of health. So yeah, basically Final Cannibal, you can both basically eat ghouls, super mutants, and humans, which is interesting, to restore your health. Let's see here. Continue to craft, so we're gonna make this, polymer combat armor. Deep pocketed. So basically this armor set is basically just made so that Curie can carry the most amount of stuff she could possibly can. So deep pockets, fortifying. And I like the polymer combat look for the thing that she's wearing currently. Now we could also do this with our weapons as well, and, you know, actually increase our own stuff, but I'm gonna save that for later, because we could probably do some weird stuff Like, we have a lot of stupid weapons, like melee weapons, that we'll probably never use. So we could definitely check those out as well. You wouldn't eat a ghoul? High cannibal standards. Nice. Well, that's pretty funny. Okay. Oh wait, deep pocketing. And fortifying. And we have 12 chips left. Cool. Awesome. Good to know. So now we have all fortified polymer combat armor that should have deep pockets. Just checking that they all deep pockets. Oops. Yeah, exit the station.
It's remarkable the things you can do with only
now,
2 hands.
Kiri, where the hell are you? I gotta re-equip you. Kiri? Damn it, Kiri. Where the frick did she go? Hey, convoy, how's it going? We started a little bit early, only to start a little bit late because there was a mod conflict and it basically replaced my power armor suit with a rusty piece of 45 power armor.
Hey.
May I be of assistance?
Okay. That's true, isn't that cannibal inception though, if you eat a ghoul who's most likely eating other human beings? So would it actually matter? That's like eating a turkey that's eaten another turkey. Actually, cows that usually eat other cows get mad cow disease, so I can see where that's a little bit iffy. Anywho, let us take her armor. Now, I wanted to go for a white look for her, because she actually used to be white painted for her robot, so I figured why not do the exact same thing. Oops. The hell? Where'd I get the other fort? Oh, did I just never? Oh, maybe I got these. I don't freaking know anymore. But yeah, now she has shoulders, chests, and legs. Cool. So now she's all clinical and nursey like she used to be. You are what you eat, I guess, right? Yeah, that's true. Alright, so let me put this other crap away. Oh, that's the stuff I got off her. That's why I was not understanding what the hell was going on. Let me just check that I have everything I need. Cool, yes. Mad snail disease. Oh my gosh, that's crazy. Anywho, I think we're good there. We've set up stuff enough, I think. Right? Yeah, we're good. Okay, so we're gonna head out. And today we're going to explore the Glowing Sea. So let's go ahead and we don't need to go for like, let's try to waste one here. 24 is pretty low. We'll go for it. Basically, you can sell these again. So I might as well just like use them for most of the way and then like stop it at some point. Okay.
Unless the next bloke we run into is armed with a can opener, I'd say we're good to go.
Alright, cool. Let's go to the Glowing Sea. Now then. I guess the closest place is, oh, we could go to Somerville Place. That works.
Easy living, this ain't.
Right. That's another bit of settlement fortifying that I did Perhaps that wasn't on camera. Yet. I basically made a hut for them to sleep in and some turrets. Nothing special. Okay. I think this is Righteous Authority, if I'm not mistaken. Am I actually heading the right way? No. It's like completely not the right way at all. We're headed this way. Okay. Now apparently you're not supposed to run and you're not supposed to like use vats too often. Interesting. regenerative Deathclaw hide-skinned armor? Oh my gosh, that'd be crazy. Now, what's our rad resistance? I kind of want to know. Oh gosh. Okay, yeah, so we got some resistance going on. Well, we saw, what was it, a legendary Deathclaw Matriarch yesterday, so we saw some pretty nasty shit. I think the one you're referring to is that one that I was just talking about. That gave us the VATS enhanced quick draw minigun. Oh, there might be a higher rank than that? Interesting. So I was reading up on the radiation damage today, and it's really weird how radiation damage works. It's not that it does both, it does one or the other. So that laser rifle I had that did like 50 radiation damage, basically it does this weird calculation. And if it's not quite enough damage for one thing, it, that's weird. A laser minigun would be pretty cool. Well, actually, we do have it.
I may have detected unusual behavior. Resuming combat operations. I am still intact.
Caps, nuclear material. I don't think we need that. Church over there. Got some rads going on, jeez. Oh yeah, there might be a Patriarch. I'm not sure which one's more deadly, though. Hope's March, Pensacola Church. Or Pentecosta? I don't know.
We appear to be under fire.
Norwegian Beach is under... Oh, fuck, really? Oh shit, there's a bunch of ghouls. Hey, the small kid, how's it going? We're in the glowing sea right now. We found like this sunken city, and there's just a whole bunch of ghouls.
Continued hostilities is not advised.
Oh, that's pretty cool. I lit them all on fire. I know, there's a whole bunch of red pips on my radar. I mean, holy crap, right? Do I have less action points when I'm wearing armor? What happened when I went offline? There was a mod conflict. And basically what happened is the armor I'm wearing now was replaced with a rusty T45 armor. Oh shit, that was not what I wanted to do. That was fantastic shot there.
So dangerous up here.
We still have so many pips on the map, holy crap. I'm gonna use this silenced up silenced shotgun. Can't believe we have a silenced shotgun. That sounds so ridiculous.
Violent tendencies greatly decrease your life expectancy.
attention. I am a good.
Yeah, 72 fusion cores. I know, right?
Where are you?
There's still more in here. Holy crap. Alright, let's see what we got. Staggering Gauss rifle. Chance to stagger on hit. Interesting. I still think our penetrating Gauss rifle is better, but that is nothing to laugh at there. That's freaking great. A cue ball.
I believe the enemy is gone.
I don't think the enemy's gone. I think it's still in here somehow.
It belongs in the garbage can, yes?
Yeah, that would be a good shotgun, you're right. God, this gun is so good, though. What is this gun? Is this a... What kind of gun is this? I forget what it is. Oh, it's a mighty advanced combat shotgun. So it does 25% more damage. And it's a freaking silencer on it, which is badass as hell. A new toy car. Cool. Office duties? Since I won't be here for tonight's service, I've hidden the key to the safe underneath the pew behind you. If you happen to need access to it for whatever reason, thank you for handling the office duties tonight. They'll keep the key and get it from you Wednesday. Hmm. And that one? Hell yeah. I know, Combo, I know. We figured that out as soon as I logged on. Dude down here too. Oh, I need the sex pee, you're right. Powered left leather arm. Okay. We can scrap that for its chips. Buff tats. It's like men tats and buff out. I do seriously suggest the survival difficulty legendary thing though. It's fantastic. I would actually have to get out of my armor and find a bed somewhere. Is there a bed in here? I don't remember seeing one. Can you sleep in an irradiated area? Like, is that a thing? Like, I feel like game mechanic wise, it would actually be a poor choice to sleep in an irradiated area for like an hour. But frickin' I don't know. That was so cute. Let's see what the buff tat is, yeah. I'm curious too. Buff tats. Strength, endurance, max HP, and perception. Wow. That's intense. I might have to do some like making of chems when I go home. Is your hair green? It's always been, since the filters. Well, it's not really a filter, is it? Hey, I didn't even see that. Plasma grenade? Sweet. Take all that crap. Brain fungus? Bottle pins? I love that I have a Vault Boy light. It's too damn cool. The Vault Boy is messing me up a bit. I'll have to say it's a little bit weird. At first I thought it was funny, but now it's just freaking weird as hell. Anywho, let's keep heading out. Let's see what else we can find. Yeah, we're gonna have to find a bed somewhere or something. Oh man, the glowing sea is so damn cool. Got over here. Dude, Do you have anything cool on our map?
Be careful. Violent engagement can result in a
variety of... Whoa, there's one right next to me! Oh shit, I forgot they did that. Oh, crap. What happened? Yeah, it would probably wreck your brain. It probably has like some sort of like increased chance to give you addiction or something like that. So wait, what happened there? Oh, that was by accident? Okay, well, just make sure you fix that. I was like, what did you do wrong? Yeah. What else do we have on our map? Looks like there's a radio station and a plane. Let's check that out. What? I don't think those rad scorpions wanted a hug. I'll just go out and say that there now. It's probably not what they wanted. They probably wanted to eat my flesh. Hey, we leveled up. Sweet. Alright, we have a chance of knocking down opponents with scoped rifles. Hell yeah. Yeah, I was wondering too, small kid. No, the convoy just made a mistake there. And, I don't know what he did. Did he accidentally ban you? Yeah, it was a misclick. That's pretty interesting, though. Is this a mod where I am? No, this is part of the actual map. We're in the Glowing Sea, which is a pretty much like where the atomic bomb fell to irradiate the rest of Boston. Which is pretty wild. Currently I'm using the X01 power armor. Which is pretty damn good. I'm using Brotherhood armor though, or Brotherhood arms, but the rest of it is X01. What the hell is over here? Was there anything else in this crashed vertebrate, or is it literally just a crashed vertebrate? I feel like this would be an excellent place to find, like, I don't know, friggin' a suit of power armor, but it literally is just a crashed vertebrate. No cave or anything like that. Fine then. See what else we can find. Kind of want to see what's over here. Oh, gotcha, okay. Oh, there is a radio beacon right there. Huh. Let's go take a look.
This glowing sea could prove to be quite faint. Someone is nearby. Perhaps enemy detected.
Ooh, they dodge. They dodge real bad. That didn't do much. Gosh, are there two legendaries? Oh gosh. Wow. That hurt a lot, whatever it did. Bullshit. Oh, really, Enderboy? Oh, thank you. That means a lot, man. There's a lot of people that stream this game. It means a lot to me, actually. Alright, well, let's see if we can't, like, try and survive this time. There was another blood bug. I don't think it was a death claw though. Okay, we're gonna do this. We're gonna take a stim pack and also use some Rataway. And I'll take some Radex, actually. We probably have less than one rad per second, but still. Oh, the vampiric ones do poison? Gotcha. Alright, we're gonna use this, this thing then.
Did you hear hostility?
Well, it mutated already.
Your pulse and vital signs are still within acceptable parameters.
Still good. VATS enhanced leather chest piece. Alright.
I believe we are supposed to file a police report, yes? And all the little things go in baggies for evidence.
Okay, there was definitely more things here. What? Let me see. Nice, Convoy. Nice. Lol. Yeah, that was some nasty poison there. Oh, it's a glowing bloat bug.
Perhaps they are friendly.
No, a bloat bug is not friendly. Crazy. Okay. Now, I thought there was another one. Gosh, we got a radioactive storm going on too. I think radiated blood. Whoa, the radiation went really high there.
God. This glowing sea could prove to be quite fatal.
Yeah, friggin' A. I thought there was another friggin' bug. How weird. I guess there isn't one this time. I'm actually fairly good at bird watching. I mean, you don't actually have to be good at bird watching, but I'm good at identifying different birds by sound and by sight and stuff like that. Alright, let's see what this place is about. Can we get like a radio signal started? Check it. Come on. Really power terminal. The fact that this thing is still working is crazy. Extends satellites. Cool, let's see what we got here then. More radio. Distress signal. Stress signal lost. Red X wore off. I think we're good though. I think I hear it. Getting quieter now? I think it is. It's not giving me the Huh. Alright, well, we might check those out later. So we got some radio signals down here to look at, I guess. And I think they'll lead us to quests actually down here, or at least caches of stuff. I don't know what though. Oh man, it is nasty out here though, holy shit. Now let's find this other place. Actually, I want to see what this is. Oh yeah, we're not supposed to sprint in power armor, I forgot. Is this supposed to be like an outdoor movie theater? I think it might be. I kind of like the Vault Boy as our little thing. Oh, there's another plane. Okay. This is a big ass plane, holy shit. What is this thing? Yeah, we're gonna try it, definitely. I think this is the Skyline Mayday.
Skylanes 1665, 20 miles out.
Roger, Skylanes 1665, traffic short final. Clear to land on runway 18 left.
Copy, 18 left. Coming in at 475 knots, that's 47. Hang on, control. Damn it, fire in left engine. We're losing power in left engine. Okay, let's put it out. Left engine to idle. Shit. No power in left engine. Boston Center.
Humanity has fallen so since the bombs.
Left engine failure. We're out 15-3 at this time.
Copy that, Skylanes 1665. Request emergency landing. Clearing runway 18 left. Can you make it?
That's a negative, Boston Center. Losing altitude too quickly. We will not make it to runway.
1665, say again.
Alright, so this is the Mayday signal from this area.
It's
mine, combat rifle. Seems good wherever that is. I think I turned on some lights or something.
Damn it, fire in left engine. We're losing power in left engine. Okay, let's put it out. Left engine to idle. Shit! We're still losing power.
The hell's that red glow coming from?
That's it. No power in left engine.
Hmm.
Boston
Weird.
Center. Skylane 1665 declaring an emergency. Left engine failure. We're out 15-3 at this time.
Copy that, Skylane 1665. Request emergency landing. Clearing runway 18 left. Can you...
Alright, let's take that away. I think most of these distress signals will probably just lead us to other places. Like, I think that other one was trying to lead us to the church, if I wasn't mistaken. Although it was kind of quiet, so I couldn't hear it. Oh, there it is. I was gonna say, where the hell is that actual, like, beeping coming from? But yeah, it's on the tail. That's pretty cool. I don't know if that's gonna start anything or cause an alarm, but that's pretty damn cool. Oh, there's more. Jeez, this thing's everywhere. I think we're gonna have to change the light. Although the Vault Boy is hilarious as part of our lighting, I don't think it's the best thing. Damn, this plane is in so many pieces. Oh shit! Just get rid of as many normal bloat flies as we can. There's a legendary bloat fly there as well. Shit. Is that at 0%? Gotcha, bitch. I didn't actually get him. What the hell? Holy shit, it's evasive as fuck. Come back here, you legendary asshole.
Default contact broken.
Oh, crap. Stop flying away. Lucky leather chest piece.
The enemy appears to be missing.
I probably should have used a shotgun in that situation. Just thinking about it now. I was not expecting to be ambushed by like 100 bloatflies though.
We may not be alone.
Come here, you bloatfly. It's still running away.
We appear to be safe now. There is something nearby. Identity unknown.
Uh-oh. I've angered other stuff as well.
We appear to have lost the enemy. I may have detected unusual behavior.
Oh, shit. Okay, well, at least we got that one.
It's dangerous. Combat is quite vigorous exercise. Is this mosquito a product of the FEV or radiation?
It's a good question, actually, that she asks.
Looking for the shooter.
There's that black bug. Jeez. Alright. Check out the rest of these places. Gosh, there's still something else over there. Friggin' bugs. Alright. Anything in here? Gosh, this plane was torn to pieces. Damn. Oh, do you mean, like, when you look up my name? I have no idea, but yeah, like, I don't know how that works. But yeah, apparently there's, like, Japanese and Russian sites that link to me or something like that. I don't know. Like, maybe it's, like, Japanese and Russian Twitch? I don't know. I feel like that'd be a good thing to, like, jetpack to. There's also that one, the fact that, there's a Vingroth, furry site, which is hilarious. Maybe we can get in there from the inside, I don't know. What is this building? Caution. This building is freaky as anything. What the hell are we walking into? Oh gosh, my radiation's going up a ton.
This used to be a military site.
Okay, let's head in here. Sentinel Site Prescott. Do I have an Instagram or Facebook? No, I don't have either of those things, at least for Vingroth.
Nuclear missiles. To think something so comparatively small could destroy so very much.
Actually, it's okay, Convoy. The game isn't like that. Actually, the first one, they, this is pretty damn cool. But yeah, it's not like that. If there is some sort of quest here, then it will actually bar the section that actually leads me to, like, that quest area.
Imminent.
Requesting assistance.
Kiri, what's going on? Did you fall? Like, all the fuck way down there? Alright, let's see what we got here. Wait. Sentinel Sight Blast Door Override. I guess that's useful, right? Open Blast Door. Yeah, the game does have a failsafe for, Oh, does it not work? Huh, it doesn't work. But yeah, basically it, like, shuts off certain areas, so you can't actually go into areas that would, start quests for you. If they weren't supposed to be started, that is. What were those? Maybe we have to restore power or something like that? We're detected for a tiny bit, which makes me worried. What about this terminal? Open blast door? Launch initiated, blast doors are closed. Force lock during launch. Okay. Oh, we're definitely going to try to shoot a nuclear missile, definitely. Oh yeah, we at least have to try to kill ourselves with giant radioactive bombs. It's a must.
Engaging evasive maneuver.
The hell sound was that? I think Kiri just killed something.
Sweet.
Oh, the lock. It is opening.
Alright. Telephone, technical documents. It's weird, technical documents, like, they don't have any value for me anymore since I'm not with the Brotherhood. So I probably shouldn't even pick them up, but at the same time, I like collecting things. So, can't stop me! Alright, let's see here. We have... Abort launch sequence. Launch sequence aborting. We can initiate the launch sequence as well. So we're gonna have to try that. So the blast doors are supposed to be... They were supposed to close because the launch was initiating. So maybe the bombs fell before they got a chance to launch it at China. I don't know.
It is very still, is it not?
Going up.
Okay, cool. This elevator does work. Man in the ceiling. I can't shoot his leg. Well, let's see what we got in here then. Now Kiri attacked something, which makes me worried. It sounded a lot like a ghoul, which makes sense for, you know, being in a silo, a bunker. Did you see that thing just... Oh, this thing's alive. I thought it was dead. Oh, it was a mole rat.
Be careful. Violent engagements can result in a variety of injuries.
Okay, so there are ghouls just, like, lying around. Good to know. I forgot that I friggin' like just land on the ground like that all the time. Can't do anything with that particular warhead. Is that thing alive? Child of the Atom. Oh, that makes sense for a Child of the Atom to be here. definitely. Alright, quick save. Nah, it doesn't seem to do it. Good try, though. Alright, let's see. Yeah, maybe we could fire. We might be able to fire a warhead, yeah. I'll have to check that out. Oh my gosh. The Vault Boy thing is so distracting. I have to change it at some point.
Nearby. Enemy detected. I hope you have no need of this stim pack, but just in case.
Oh, did she give me a stim pack? Cool. Just a mole rat there. Actually, I'll take the mole rat hide because I could use leather, actually. I mean, we have no idea. It could just blow us all up. That is definitely a possibility. Oh, hi there! God, why is my VATS aim so bad? Legendary go. Ooh, Martyr's combat armor left leg. Temporary slows down time when you're at 20% or less health. Cool. I already have a martyr piece of armor, and I don't think two is gonna increase the effect any, so it's better just to have the one. A site for storing defective nukes. I feel like that's the worst thing ever. Why do you only shoot the head? The head deals more damage if you can shoot it. The body, it's easier to hit, but it doesn't do as much. So that's why I usually aim for the head. I could technically aim for the legs, and it would actually cause them to be crippled. So we could also do that, but sometimes hitting the legs is a lot harder to do. So it's all the preference of how you want to approach combat. But yeah, the head usually does more damage. But luckily next, so like, yeah, the head's 48 and the torso's 95. You can see it does that much damage right now. So it does roughly a bit over half, but if you use the head, he's almost dead. Now we could try just like tearing off a leg. Okay, well, that didn't quite take me down. The number's the percent chance that you'll hit the guy. So 95 is basically 95% chance you'll hit during VATS. So for instance, there are certain perks that'll actually increase that. Which one of them I'm aiming for right now. So at level 54, the next level, I can get a sniper 8. And so scoped rifles gain a 25% accuracy to headshots. So my headshots will be a lot easier to hit once I actually get that perk. Take that. No, you can see the damage by it actually shows their health flashing, and that'll tell you how much damage that you're about to do. Or that you're gonna approximately do. It usually isn't the same for some reason. Right, I'm gonna switch out a core, actually. Let's see. I think I can do this. Just go into ammo. And I can't equip that item. Are you sure? Yeah. Okay. We're gonna try to. Oh, I can't exit my armor here. Okay. So that's 14%. We'll take that out. I think we have a few that are. Yeah, 70. So we can put that in. I don't want it to run out on its own because they're worth like 200 a piece. So if I have like friggin' 72 of them, we could do some nice stuff with that. Let's head this way first. So 74, that's the 74 chance to hit. And you can see the flashing health is the amount of damage I do. So you can see it's a lot less if I hit like an arm or something like that. But it's a lot more effective if I hit the head.
A whole lot less of that. Be careful. Violent engagements can result in a variety of injuries.
Okay, I think we're all right.
We should wear life preservers here. I'd much rather.
That one woke up. There we go.
So violent.
Cunning leather right leg. Agility and perception. Yeah, you don't get great legendary items from those guys, as we found out yesterday. I'm not sure what gives the best stuff. I know gunners would probably have some good weapons if you find legendary gunners. And I would assume Deathclaws, because I got a legendary flamer from one, which was awesome. I wish there was a silenced laser. That'd be so damn cool. I don't know how it would work. Actually, normally lasers are silent. So like, to a certain extent, like, it should actually be silent on its own. But. Interesting. A dead legendary. Either it appeared dead or something else is down here with me besides the ghouls. How much legendary parts do I need for each effect? Let's see. For Curie's armor, her fortifying armor, which gives her +1 strength and +1 endurance, costed 5 chips. So that's 5 legendaries recycled to make one legendary of that type. Now, I was looking through and there's one that costs 30 chips, and that's basically the stealth boy one that makes you invisible when you crouch, which honestly is probably one of the more annoying legendary items because they really haven't worked out how to have you be invisible and look at your stuff at the same time.
Apologies if sometimes I make little sense. I will work on this.
Yeah, so we may need a couple legendary parts. I would love to make like an instigating Gauss rifle. Oh, it's coming down. And
my time is up.
Oh shit. Gotta stop him before he tries to resurrect everybody. Oh, that was close. Yeah, it's actually pretty fair. I mean, you can get different versions of it. If you find it on the Nexus, there's actually a few different versions you can get. And I chose the legendary, or not the legendary, the survival version. But there's like other versions you can have where you can literally, like... So, for instance, if I wanted to take the... the freezing. So if I wanted to take the cryo off of my gun, like, I think this is easy, legendary modding, but what you do is you could take the freezing off of it and you still have the weapon and everything, but, and then you could just apply it to something else. But I thought that was way too easy. Oops. See you, Carrie. I thought it's way more balanced to basically just scrap, like, a whole bunch of items to make the legendary item of your choice. Plus, it actually gives a use for those legendary items that you're not using, which is awesome. Let's go slow and see. There's also, apparently, like, the cheat version as well. So, you know, there's that. Did we really explore that whole area? Let me go back in just a second. I think we might have. Weird. This map, like, barely shows anything. Huh. Alright then. Oh, we should probably help our place out. Whoops. Let's go ahead and do that. Because, you know, they're under attack. That'd be bad if I didn't help them out. I forgot about that. Whoops. I'm a terrible leader. I'm like out on my own adventure. I'm like, you can handle it. Oh, nice! Freaking misses there. Ow. Did you see his head just explode? That was awesome.
Your karma's paying off.
That was awesome.
Shouldn't the coroner be doing that instead?
Oh, the junk jet. It'd be interesting. I could give that a try. Wait, what? Lol. That's the funniest thing I heard. Holy crap. Damn it, they wrecked my shit again. Assholes. Does this mean a Verbird's gonna come by and crash like it did last time? Because that was awful. Alright, let's fix some crap then. Because they messed up our water pump. Although I think the water pump's actually okay. Oh, there's a tunnel that I missed? Oh, okay. I'll take a look at that then. I didn't realize I missed a tunnel. I thought it seemed to end too quickly. Okay. I think all those are good. This place is pretty well, damn well defended, I gotta say. I'm surprised that
can't get over
friggin'
what happened to
this even happened.
Losing a daughter like that.
We have 16 right people, though. Didn't say we had 17?
I don't know how they can keep
I know what, let me get an extra like bed in.
Poor girl. She had more courage than sense.
The hoarder cannon?
There we go.
Cool. I think we'll head back to our house because I want to switch out that vault light. And I probably want to empty out a bit of my inventory. And heck, we might as well try to make some crazy-ass weapons. Because why not? We can totally do it.
So, interesting thing I heard about.
Okay, so let's take this up.
There are stories about...
There we go.
That doesn't look half bad.
Okay,
only
let's
thing
see
better
here.
Than getting pissed is picking a fight. Am I right?
Oh wow, we can add legendary modifications to my power armor. Oh shit. Almost unbreakable. Quadruples durability. There's damage from humans bolstering. Oh my gosh. Well, this opened up a whole new realm of holy shit.
Nothing's more satisfying than a smoking gun and a pocket full of caps.
Actually, what's weird is we'd have legendary armor on top of legendary armor. My mind is blown. It doesn't seem like the Children of Adam are a place that, or a faction that you can join. That'd be pretty damn cool. I know, legendary power armor? I know, freaking A, right? Hey, we can actually make the plasionucleic lining. That's cool. I mean, it costs... That's like five chips. Five chips, so it's like normal. I want to see if we can't get some,
What I wouldn't give for a good stiff drink.
Yeah, we want this. We definitely want VATS enhanced. Yeah, VATS enhanced. And let's get rid of the Vault Boy. Let's get a red tactical lamp. I'm not sure what the tactical does, but VATS matrix overlay, I think, increases the chance to hit in VATS. Oh man. Let's make this totally VATS enhanced, like, completely.
As long as there's some excitement at the end of the road.
Alright, let's do this. Let's go through all the stupid weapons. Okay, let's see what we can do here. That's unique, so I'm not going to do that. I don't care about that. I want to keep that. I don't care about that. That's dumb. Dumb. It's okay. I'll keep it, why not? Yeah, the small kid. It's the helmet from some of the stuff in the past games, which is awesome. I don't want that. We're okay taking that out. Those are advanced. We'll get rid of this as well. I kind of like the explosive, so we'll keep that. We'll keep the freezing missile launcher, because why not? Ghoul Slayers we don't need. Okay, no problem. I'm keeping the aluminum rolling pin because that thing's hilarious. We don't need a Hunter's Institute rifle. I'll keep the incendiary stuff. The instigating's so fantastic. So I found out what irradiated does. Irradiated is so freaking useless. So get this. 50. That 50 radiation translates to 5% of their health taken away. 5%. Okay. Here's what it calculates. When I shoot a person, it chooses, does it deal more damage with the weapon or does it deal more damage with the radiation? Then it picks one. And that's the damage it does. So that 5% would only be useful if I was fighting someone who had a ridiculous amount of health. Otherwise, it would just do 98 damage the whole time. Oh, we can get rid of all these junkies. I'll keep the kneecapper. Let's see. That's an interesting sniper rifle, actually. Let's see. What else do we have? Mutant Slayers, don't care about. We can get rid of the Nimble. Penetrating, I don't care about. That would be this. See, that's what I want to see. I'm a Doge fan. A legendary rolling pin effect of cooks that, like, you hit the animal and it freaking makes them into cooked food. They just explode into steaks. That'd be amazing. Actually, that'd be good for the flamer as well. Like, you make a chef's flamer, and then you like and you're friggin' like flaming everything, and then like a ragstag just explodes into ragstag steaks. It'd be amazing. Alright, we don't need a powerful baton. Fuck that. I'm okay for the quick draw stuff. I do like rapid stuff. Rapid's pretty awesome. Kellogg's pistol already does this. I will keep the staggering baton, because you can actually add something to the staggering baton that actually adds more stagger, which is crazy. We don't need troubleshooters. Yeah, we don't need troubleshooters. I like the two shots. That's enhanced. We'll take one of those away. Alright, so we're going to recycle all of those weapons that we just did. Okay, so... scrap it. Next. Don't need the assassin stuff.
Someone asked me to shag is getting a well-placed kick.
So we're getting chips from all these is what we're doing. That's one of ours, so we're not recycling that. All the junkies. That's one of the things we're using. Mutant Slayers, getting rid of that. Don't want any of those. That's the one we want to keep. Penetrating pipe wrench.
Up to next.
Don't need a powerful baton. Speaks in animal language. We don't need that. Oh man, we can upgrade our friggin' assault rifle. Holy shit. I didn't even think about that, but we could totally do it. I've been looking to upgrade that thing for a long ass time. Do we need a staggering Gauss rifle?
Full bottle and some bones to break.
I'll leave it. Targeting boosted agitated improved automatic laser pistol. Look at the amount of shit you get for recycling that motherfucker. Holy crap. That's awesome. Yes. We're gonna have, like, the coolest shit ever.
Getting dark out. Maybe we should find a place to bed down for the night.
Okay. Now, to double check something, we're gonna go and press Q. And if something's missing, I know something's gone wrong, so I think we're okay. Cool. So, let me store all junk. Let's see what we can craft. So, we have our Recon Advanced Assault Rifle with a legendary modification. Is Eastern Time 1 hour ahead of Central or what? Central Time, so, for me, my time right now is 7:33. Central Time would be 6:33. So, we're an hour ahead or something. I think that's how it works. So let's go shopping, shall we? Oh my gosh, we could literally pick anything. Now, I've heard that wounding stacks, which sounds stupid, ridiculously powerful, and will probably be patched out anyway, but that is super freaking tempting. Basically, I want this thing to do a ton of damage. 25% damage and limb damage, but it has more recoil, probably not. That's enhanced. Two shot. God damn. If you're not in combat yet, increases VAT's accuracy but costs more action points. Yeah, no problem. Staggering. Chance to stagger on hit. Oh man, you fire so fast with this thing. Staggering would be crazy. Fills your action points on a critical hit. Faster fire rate and faster reload. Just costs less action points. So 25% more damage. Poison effect. Plasma infused. Plasma infused sounds friggin' great. Already do penetrating. Gosh. Unlimited ammo capacity. Heals targets instead of hurting them.
Nothing's more satisfying.
Critical shots deal double damage and the critical meter fills 15% faster. So that's kind of like... righteous whatever the hell. junkies, irradiated apparently doesn't do shit, instigating. This is where hoarding comes in handy, because now I can do all this shit, which is awesome. 15 points of fire damage. Let's see, increases damage after each consecutive hit on the same target. That could be interesting. A sniper headshot to heal dog meat, right? That could be interesting. So each consecutive hit on the same target increases the damage. That is something to consider. Actually, what's cool is now we can see all the legendary things we can have in the game. Crowd damage. Okay.
I see how you're looking at me. Not saying I don't like it.
Yeah, Bakori, yeah. I took a look at it. And it seems like it's a little bit overpowered, but that's only because I've been collecting everything since the beginning of the game, and I've scrapped basically most of my legendary weapons. So now I have 34 chips to work with. This is a tough one.
Only thing better than getting pissed is picking.
I'm thinking for this, we either go with Furious. So increased damage after each consecutive hit on the same target, which sounds freaking amazing. Yes, I'm a Doge fan. I just forgot off camera. So Furious would be a fantastic one. And plasma infused would be pretty damn cool as well. You know what? I think we're gonna go with Furious. Because usually I'm pretty good with my aim with this thing, so it'd be insane to just basically keep shooting, and the more I shoot, the more damage I do. Yeah, we're gonna go with Furious.
Wow.
So Furious Advanced Assault Rifle. Shit, yeah. Let's see what else we can do. Now, can we... I wonder. So, like, can I go to... penetrating. Okay, so I can actually switch these out. Oh my gosh. Do you know what this means?
Rain is soaking right through me clothes.
Instigating shielded Gauss rifle. Deals double damage if the target's at full health. Shit. I feel like that's not completely balanced yet. Because most of these seem to be 5. Okay, so some of them are more. I feel like instigating should be a lot harder to get.
We'd move faster if you kept your eyes on the road and off me arse.
Well, that's freaking crazy. Oh gosh, what else can we do? You take everything back, it's not fair. I'm starting to think that that's not fair either. Yeah, I don't know about that.
Can't wait to get out of this goddamn heat.
I think just so this playthrough doesn't take like a strange turn and I just like friggin' have the best weapons of all time, I'm gonna turn this back into it what it was, which was penetrating, I believe. Yeah. That seems a bit overpowered to just all of a sudden have an instigating Gauss rifle.
I don't mind hoofing it as long as there's some excitement at the end of the road.
Keep Overseer's Guardian the way it is. Actually, you know what I want to do with Overseer's Guardian? I didn't like the suppressor. Oh yeah, like, it should totally take, like, probably 10 chips, maybe even 30. It seems a bit odd, doesn't it? But let's take these. I want to go for a muzzle break. Yeah, I think we want a muzzle break for this one, actually. Because I think that worked a little bit better and kept my recoil low. Anywho, what else can we do that isn't completely overpowered and, like, would mess with me? Oh, you know what I want?
I have so much data.
I would love to have an explosive laser weapon. I think that would be freaking intense. Let's do that.
Nothing's more satisfying than a smoking gun.
Okay, so we're gonna do this. So we're gonna self-employ some sort of a gimp for ourselves so that we don't, like, basically have the best stuff forever. Because otherwise I could have, like, instigating everything, which would be insane. But anywho. I want to get... I need some sort of laser weapon. I've been looking for a good laser weapon for the longest time, so I might as well just make one. Let's see. I think we'll use a normal laser rifle as opposed to a an Institute. How'd I get a focus boosted Institute? Okay. How's its damage compare if I add a beam amplifier is 35. Yeah, I mean, we could, yeah, technically everything with two shot would be amazing. Oh man, imagine a two shot friggin' missile launcher. We're better off with a normal laser rifle, I think. Did I accidentally take this and not a laser rifle? I think I did. Whoops. Damn it. So we're gonna put Righteous Authority away. Oops. Righteous Authority. And freaking A. That thing. There we go.
Walking around at night isn't the smartest thing to be doing around here.
We're gonna go for an overcharged capacitor. We're gonna go for a. Oh, do you know what I want? Oh, do you know what I want for this? Improved sniper barrel. Recoil compensating. Let's see. Short recon scope.
All this walking's wearing me out.
I already have a few legendary revolvers. Amplified beam splitter. Oh, I already had one. Weird. And this is going to be explosive. Yeah.
Next person that asked me to shag is getting a well-placed kid.
Yeah.
If you get me.
Let's see how this works. Explosive overcharged laser sniper rifle. Oh, weird. It doesn't actually shoot lasers anymore. What? It doesn't shoot lasers. What? I'm so confused. Is that normal? Maybe this isn't a mod this weapon's supposed to have. I don't know about that.
Off to next.
Let's try a plasma infused instead, maybe. I think, yeah, I broke it there. Let's try something where the lasers don't disappear. Okay, let's try a plasma infused overcharged laser sniper rifle. Yeah, it shoots particles, right? That's so weird. Okay, cool. So it shoots like... Oh man, it's like the Christmas rave gun. We might work with this. It doesn't have that much ammo capacity, but it'd still be pretty damn cool. Actually, would it be better if it wasn't a scatter gun?
Only thing better than getting pissed is picking a fight. Am I right?
It shoots laser plasma. I know, friggin' A. This is too damn cool. So, if I just make it like this... I think that gives me increased... Maybe not. It's like a firework. I know, it's pretty damn cool, isn't it? What else could we do with this thing? The explosive did not work with that. Maybe that works better with a shotgun. I mean, that gave me a horrible idea, but there you go. We could make it incendiary. I don't know. I like the idea of adding plasma to it, though. That's why it's a plasma-infused laser, which just doesn't make any sense, but is damn cool as hell. I think we'll work with it. But I think we might change the sniper barrel to a improved long barrel, maybe. Shotgun RPG. Sometimes he is, sometimes he isn't. Let's see. Let's see. I mean, the sniper barrel does a lot more damage, but at the same time, I don't get a lot of shots out of it. We're gonna get more shots out of this, I think. Improved long barrel. I think we might just go with a quantum gyro for reduced recoil. It'll be pretty damn cool, regardless. Actually, now that you bring it up, I have to try. Okay. I have to see if this works. Alright, we're gonna take a missile launcher. Granted, I have to, like, scroll through, like, 1,000 frickin' things. Missile launcher. Just want one. Okay. So we take a missile launcher. We're gonna give it a quad barrel. We're gonna give it a targeting computer. We're gonna give it a stabilizer.
Humanity is so resilient.
Well, we're not gonna go crazy. I mean, the most I did was add Furious to my, to my gun. We're basically wasting a lot of, like, junk stuff right now, but I feel like that balances out the fact that we get to choose whatever we want. I want to see if this works. A two-shot quad-barrel missile launcher. I just want to see if it works. We may never use it, but holy shit if it works. Actually, I never thought, what if we do, like, a two-shot, but with a weapon that does a shotgun? Ooh. Okay. Testing. Does it shoot two missiles at the same time? Yes, it does. That's too damn cool! Holy shit! That's amazing. Okay, we're putting this away because I can't possibly. That was just a test. That is too damn cool. Cool. Alright, that's enough crazy legendary modification for now. I think we're fine with a plasma-infused laser rifle. And a Furious... assault rifle. For the cost of sacrificing basically all the other legendary shit we had. Um, I could probably make a Merv launcher double shot. Yeah, I probably could. But we're not going to go crazy here, because a lot of these weapons... Well, that one I probably will never use, because it'd just be too insane. But, basically, it needs to have a rebalance, I think. Like, some of those things should probably cost way more chips than they should. But, yeah. I mean, if you want to see it for science, we can do that. Alright, let's do some science with this, because I want to see if this is possible. So we're going to quick save. We'll turn on God mode, because you don't actually use up materials in God mode. So we're going to take a fat man. Okay. And where's our fat man? And, oh, it doesn't, oh, wow, okay, so that doesn't work. I can make it explosive, that's a bit weird. Or instigating. Oh, maybe you can't choose everything. Unless these only cost two. Nah, it doesn't look like a fat man can actually use some of these things. Like, I can use instigating. Oh, but you know what? I've already made these. Maybe that's why. Never-ending fat man. Yeah, that's the crazy one, isn't it? I would have to get more chips, though. I don't really have that. That'd be pretty crazy, though. Can I use two shot? It's there, but I can't use it. Here, let's go F9. I've got some armor to put away, so I might be able to scrap that. I want to see if a two-shot laser with a beam amplifier shoots twice the amount of scattered lasers. I think that'd be really cool to figure out. We don't really need that. Or that. The martyr stuff's pretty good, though. Okay, that gave us... I don't know how many more. A never-ending double-barrel shotgun. Yeah. See, it could get crazy. I mean, this stuff that technically, I guess, that you could normally find, like, in the world, but at the same time, it's very, now that you have a choice over it, it's kind of crazy what you can do. Alright, so let me see something here. How many chips do I have to work with? Okay, I have 7 chips to work with, which can apparently get everything, except two-shot. Two-shot requires 8 chips. I think two-shot should probably be around 35, honestly. Okay. Let's do some science. Well, let's store all the junk, too. Quick saving. Now then, we'll take a fat man, we'll bring it to the workbench. Now we're going to give it a... Let's give it a two shot and see what happens. Okay. They do not have a recharger rifle, or at least I haven't found one yet. Which is unfortunate. I really hoped they would have had a recharger rifle. But technically that was in Fallout New Vegas, which, like, Todd Howard doesn't even acknowledge as being something that was made. Alright, so let's see if it shoots two fat men. Yes, it does. Yep. Two shot works. Okay, so quick load. Then we'll try never ending, because that sounds crazy. Never ending. Oh, and Merv. The Merv, I find the Merv to be really disappointing. Alright, War, so we're going to try this right now. Where was it? Never ending? Okay. Okay, so. Yeah, that totally works.
It's abandoned.
Okay, let's try to put a MIRV on it and see what happens.
So I guess, I mean, something must have happened, right? And it must have been.
I'm not a fan of the MIRV, actually, because it really just, like, anyway, I don't know. Right. Like, if you want to attack something that far away, that's fine, but otherwise. Among men! That's amazing! I have to wait for my fucking eyesight to come back from all that nuclear radiation. Let's do it! Happy New Year! Oh my gosh. Oh, it's amazing. Holy shit. I love science. Okay. That was awesome. I'm trying to think what else would be pretty friggin' cool. Okay, so I do want to try this.
Hey, have you seen the
Trigum is alive. It's so overpowered. Yeah, I think the chips should cost a bit more.
Something?
Yeah, I really do. That's why we're going to limit ourselves, so that we don't end up making that.
Correct.
Because that's crazy.
And you know, of course, the mayor, I mean.
Okay, I want to try, let's see.
I have a statement from the mayor's office.
Actually, you know what I'll do? I'll take the... Because I think these are fully upgraded, most of them.
You know.
I even made I made them hostile, because I probably killed everybody, and they just immediately disliked me. Let's see.
Anyway, it's something to think about, I guess. Elton Britt. Next to the song.
Or was it Rapid? Yeah, Rapid. Okay, so we're gonna take a Rapid Institute rifle.
Here's Uranium Fever.
Or this one. This one works too.
Well, I don't know, but I've been told uranium ores.
That was weird that actually gave me that weapon again. It just brought to my attention now. So let's try this. It's true. So let's try this. We're going to replace the Rapid with... what the hell was it going to do? Rapid with two shot. And we're going to compare to see if it actually doubles the amount of split lasers or just gives me one extra laser. So we're also going to put a... Let's see, where is it? Amplified beam splitter. Okay. Test this out. So, let's see here. So, we have a plasma infused overcharged laser rifle, which shoots that many lasers. It looks like 5 or 6. Now, is this going to shoot 10 to 12 because it's a two shot. I don't know. Make her carry a never-ending minigun. Holy crap, I don't know. It doesn't look like it shoots more lasers. I thought it would, like, double the amount of lasers that it would split into, which would just be insane. Okay, let's turn this one back to normal.
I wonder if the data I'm collecting will serve any purpose.
You like the never-ending Merv? It's pretty crazy. Yeah, so it definitely does shoot two. But adding the, then adding a splitter really doesn't do much. I mean, it might shoot like one extra one, but it doesn't seem to... Yeah, I think it shoots one extra laser. That's a shame. I thought it would split into like many. That's cool though. Alright, so let me just summarize what the hell just happened there, because there was a lot of quick loading and shit like that. Also, let's take ourselves out of God mode. So, basically, we did some testing, and we basically recycled most of our surplus legendary weapons, and what we did was we added Furious to our assault rifle, which is probably one of my favorite weapons, and now is going to be even another one of my favorite weapons because it increases damage after each consecutive hit on the same target. It's going to be awesome. Will I make her a sexy minigun? I don't know. I mean, yeah, technically, let's make Curious something, should we? I think we should. I don't know what we'd make her, though. And then the other thing that we did was we made a laser rifle that was plasma infused. And in doing so, we, like, scrapped, like, a ton of stuff. Also, I think... Do I have the weapon modifications on me? Because I think I'll drop them just to be, or disable them. Just to be a little bit more fair. That never-ending Merv was hilarious, though. In fact, I'm actually going to unmod the other thing, too. What was it? Oops. Just to be fair, because, like... Granted, you know, this is a mod, and I'm, like... It's a fine balance between, like, actually taking the balance out of the game. I mean, we're already doing, like, badass as it is. We really don't need anything else, technically. So, what was the other thing we had? We had a two-shot quad-barrel missile launcher that we made that we should just probably get rid of. Yeah. Scrap it. I have to scrap it. Yeah, we don't need that. let's see here. Combat rolling pin? Holy shit, that'd be amazing. Okay, so... Now, what should we make her? Oh, I have some weapon mods I also want to get rid of as well. Let's see. Inventory. Mods. So, we want to get rid of these ones, then. Because, yeah. Didn't we have a two-shot to get rid of as well? So we're just going to disable these. There we go. That's a little bit more fair. A never-ending rolling pin. Yeah, I'm not sure what I'd give her, though. Now that I think about it. I mean, it has to be a weapon that does, like, a decent amount of damage. But at the same time, like, I don't know. Because she has a 45 automatic weapon that has incendiary. I wouldn't know what to give her, actually. I mean, I could give her a minigun, but at the same time, I feel like modding a minigun is a little bit over our heads this time. We're going to stick with that, then. Let's save there and head back to the Loving Sea. I don't have that much time left, actually. So let's see. Fusion core is at 42. We can run with that.
Can't wait to get out of this goddamn heat.
Oh, yeah. We were going to make the parts of this armor friggin' legendary. I think we're okay, though. We got some good stuff. Okay, so, let's head back to the Glowing Sea. And apparently we missed a spot in this, Sentinel site. Well, no, no, today's a bit different. Fridays, I end about, like, a half an hour earlier than normal. Normally, yes, I would have about another hour, but I end a bit earlier on Fridays because I have a tabletop game that I play. Actually, in this case, it is actually D&D, so I don't have to use another example. It's pretty cool. I play a, basically, it's a world where we made our own history, which is awesome. So it's not like we're waiting for, or, you know, we're going off of a rule book. Like, we actually made the history of the entire game that we're playing, which is cool. And I play a bullywog rogue thief. Which is basically like a frog. So like a human-sized frog. Yeah, Dungeons and Dragons, yep. Yes, I am in fact that nerdy. Yeah, I wouldn't know what to give Curie, anyway.
Going up.
Maybe off camera I'll like mess around a bit, but I feel like we've done enough legendary manipulation today, so. Oh yeah, I think we can go in some of these doors upstairs, actually. Let me check that out. Well, these are my fists, lol. So this is the plasma-infused rifle, I think. Yep,